Today I am going to explain you the third chapter of supplementary reader, The Shepherd's Treasure. Shepherd's treasure means whatever the collection shepherd is having. I explain you the word shepherd. Shepherd means a person whose job is to look after sheep. And the treasure means the collection of valuable things like gold, silver, jewelry, etc. So this is the third chapter of supplementary reader. You will come to know what actually the treasure of shepherd was there. In the first part, you will come to know three things. A poor shepherd once lived in Iran. Though uneducated, he was very wise and helpful. The king decided to meet him in discourse. In discourse means king decided when he came to know about that shepherd that he was very intelligent, he was very helpful. He decided to meet him, but being a king, he could not go to him. So he decided that he will change his appearance. Then he would go and meet him. So this is the explanation. In a village in Iran, there once lived a shepherd. He was very poor. He did not even have a small cottage of his own. He had never been to school or learned to read and write, for there were very few schools in those days. The first paragraph says that he was living in a village in Iran. He was very much poor. Those days very few schools were there in that village. And the poverty limit, you may see that he is not having his own cottage in the village, then how could he spend the money for study? So this was the reason. He had never been to school, so he was not he didn't learn to read and write. Though poor and uneducated, this shepherd was very wise. But there was different thing in his personality, that he was poor and uneducated, then also he was very much wise, very intelligent. As he understood the people's sorrows and troubles easily and helped them face their problems with courage and common sense. And he was unable to help the people, those who were in need, by providing money. Then also he was helping the persons, those who were in the problem, by courage, by common sense, what he was having. Many people came to him for advice, and because of his this nature, many people were coming to him for taking advice only. Such intelligent person he was, such wise person he was, people were coming to take from him advice. Soon he became famous for his wisdom and friendly nature. Slowly he became famous for his wisdom as well as for his friendly nature, helping nature. The king of that country heard about him and thought of meeting him. When king also came to know about his nature, about his wisdom, he also decided that he would go and meet to that shepherd. Disguised as a shepherd and riding on a mule. So after deciding to meet him, the king changed himself as a shepherd. His changed appearance was a shepherd, and he took one mule. Mule is an animal. Mule is an animal that is used to load, to carry the loads. In Hindi we say it khachar. So he took one mule, and riding on it, he reached to the cave where the shepherd man was living. As soon as the shepherd saw the traveler coming towards the cave, as soon as the shepherds found that the person is coming towards his cave, he rose to welcome him. The nature of shepherd, now I am explaining you, that he took the tired traveler inside the cave. gave him water to drink. So this all is what? This all is called hospitality. If someone is coming to you, first of all, we are making him sit, providing water, the same he treated. Provided water to drink, share his own meagre meal. Meagre meal means a small amount of food he was having. That also he had given to this traveler, that okay, you enjoy it, share it. The king rested for the night in the cave and was greatly impressed by the shepherd's hospitality and wise conversation. The way the shepherd man treated the traveler and the way he discussed wisely with the traveler, these all things impressed the king very much. The second part of the chapter, you will come to know, the shepherd was able to make out that the visitor was none other than the king. He understood the strange person who came to meet him. He was the king of the area. The king made the wise shepherd governor of a small district. Other governors, when he became the governor of a small district, other governors became jealous of him. Though still tired, the king decided to depart the next morning. The king was very tired. Then also he decided that next morning he will go from there. He said, "Many thanks for your kindness to a poor traveler." The king thanked him by saying that your kindness was worth appreciable for a poor person, poor traveler. I have a long way to go. Now the king, the traveler, had to complete his journey for a long way. So he took permission. He requested that shepherd, okay, allow me now to go. Looking straight into the eyes of the guest, the shepherd replied, but the shepherd was very intelligent. He looked at him, he looked at the traveler and said, "Thank you. Your Majesty, we are using to address the king, Maharaj." He said, "Thank you, sir, because for paying me the compliment of a visit. Whatever words you have told me on your visit, the complimentary word, whichever thanks you have told me, you had given to me, for that I am thanking you." The king was astonished as well as pleased. On listening it, the king became very much surprised, as well as he was very happy to understood the nature of that shepherd. "He is indeed very wise," he thought to himself. The king thought to himself that yes, this person is very smart, very intelligent, and he thought, "I needed people like him to work for me." The king decided that such type of persons were required in his kingdom to work for him. And then the king appointed that shepherd as the governor of a small district. Although he rose to power and dignity, the shepherd remained as humble as ever. Being governor, now the shepherd was having power in his hand and dignity also, but then also he remained humble. Humble means polite, soft spoken, as he was earlier. People loved and honored him for his wisdom, sympathy and goodness. The nature, the quality which he was having, because of that he was liked and loved and honored by the people. And those qualities were his wisdom, his sympathy for others and his goodness. He was kind and just to one and all. He was not having any partiality in his mind for the people. He was very fair, just governor of the area. His fame as a fair and wise governor soon spread throughout the country. And this nature of that governor, newly appointed governor, the one who was a shepherd, spread it throughout the country. Now the governors or other provinces grew terribly jealous of him. Provinces means the other parts of countries. There were different governors Now they were very much jealous of that newly appointed governor. They said he was very dishonest. Now they started speaking ill words for him to make him defame. So he started saying that he was very dishonest. He was keeping a part of money that he was collecting as tax from the persons, people. And to prove this, that he was taking money, he also added that why he was having iron chest with him. Definitely, whatever money he was collecting from the persons, he was keeping in that chest. Iron chest means a box of iron. Perhaps he carried it in it the treasure that he had secretly collected, and assured that definitely he was collecting the money, collecting the tax from the people, and whatever treasure he was having, he is storing that treasure in that iron chest. After all, they said mockingly, he was an ordinary shepherd and could behave no better. And then also they added one line, see, this is all because he was a poor shepherd. So how he would behave nicely. Now the third and last part of the chapter will explain that the new governor was called to the palace. He was ordered to explain why he always carried an iron chest. In that last part, you will come to know that he was ordered to come in the palace by the king. And then he was asked why he was having the iron chest always with him. And the chest contained no gold and silver. And you will come to know what actually treasure he was having in that iron chest. At first, the king did not pay attention to these reports. Earlier, when the king was listening to all the things, all nonsense about this newly appointed governor, he didn't pay any attention. But now the complaints were too many. He could not ignore these governors and their endless stories about the shepherd. He had to take care of it. And one thing was striking to the king's mind also was iron chest. Why he was having iron chest with him always? The new governor did carry an iron chest with him all the time. This was the thing that king also would like to find out. So one day the new governor was summoned to the palace. So one day he was called by the king in the palace. He came riding on his camel. Now being a governor, he was using camel. So he came there riding on his camel. And to everyone's delight, the famous iron chest was there fastened securely behind him on the camel's back. And it was fun. It was delightful thing for the other, those who were standing in the palace, was that the mysterious iron chest. That iron chest was tied on the back of the camels. So, back of camel. So, everyone was very happy that again, means here also he reached having the iron chest with him. Now, the king was very angry to see him with the iron chest. So, he thundered. He spoke in very loud voice. Why do you always carry that iron chest with you? He put the first question only. Why he always had that iron chest with him? What does it contain? Again he asked one question. What it contain? Governor smiled and he asked his servant to bring in the chest. He smiled and he told his servant that bring that chest. How eagerly the people standing around he waited for the shepherd to be found. And when he ordered his servant to bring the chest, other governors, those who were standing in the court, they were too much eager to see, to think that now he would be founded out by the king actually what he was. But how great was their astonishment, the and even of the king himself, when the chest was opened. But when the chest was opened, it was a great surprise for the governors, those who were standing there, and for the king also. Why? Because there was no gold, no silver, no jewelry in that iron chest. Actually, it was having an old blanket. That was the treasure in that. And holding up proudly that blanket, the shepherd said, "This, my dear master, is my only treasure." He explained to the king by saying that, "Sir, this was my only treasure which I was containing in this iron chest. And always I carry it means he was carrying it with him always. "But why do you carry such an ordinary blanket with you?" The question put one question. The king asked one question, why he was carrying such an old blanket always with him. Because now he was the governor of his district. For these two questions, the new governor answered that, "Sir, this blanket is my oldest friend." This was actually his oldest friend. "It will still protect me if any time your majesty should wish to take away my new clothes." He very nicely explained, "Sir, you had provided me this post, and after appointing on this post of a governor, I am having a coat which the governors are wearing. In case, if any time you ordered me to give you back this post, if you ordered me to take back your coat, that time this my oldest friend would help me. That is my old blanket." It says that we should be ready for each and any circumstances of each and every circumstances of life. We should be ready to face it. Very good answer was given by the new governor, and listening this, the king became very pleased, very much happy. And how embarrassed and jealous governors became. The other governors, those who were having doubts in their minds, those who were waiting there in the palace that he would be proved dishonest, they all became very much shy and uncomfortable to listen the wise man's words. Now they knew that the shepherd was indeed the humblest and the wisest man in the land. Now it was proved, and they also understood that really that shepherd man was excellent in intelligence as well as in goodness. The king made him the governor of much bigger district that very day. At the same time, the king announced that he would be the governor of a bigger district from today, from that day only. So this is the very messaging story, having good message, that how rich, how prosper, how much powerful we are becoming in our life. Then also we should never forget those days which we faced, when we faced the hardship of life to achieve this all power, money and authority. Then only we can rule properly. Then only we can feel the poverty, the hardshipness, the bad conditions of the poor one where we are living. So this is the message of this chapter. We should never forget our olden days. Okay, students, bye.